Okay, if you remember, I showed you the last slide for the last session was about combinations, and the formula was shared with you. Now, based on combinations and probability based theorem as well, let us see some examples. Please note down this as well if you have not done it before. Okay, to begin with, the first problem which I'll be taking, note down this. We have four cards which are drawn at random from a pack of 52 cards. Find the probability that they are king, a queen, a jack, and an ace. Okay, this is my first question. The second part, two are kings and two are jacks. And the third one, all are clubs. Okay, and one more, all are red or all are blacks. So if you look at the problem here given, immediately you can say that for the first problem, as we have one card from each of kings, queens, and jack and aces. As you know, there are four kings altogether. Okay, so it's a combination. We can write 4C1. That will be the first one. Then similarly for queen also, we'll get 4C1 and for jack and for ace. Now, four cards are drawn at random. So if I want to find the probability, the formula for the first one, if you can try it out and give me the solution. Total number of cards in a pack is 52. So what are the different combinations? On 52 cards, we have 52C4. Okay, four cards are drawn. So if I want to find out the probability that one is king, the other one is queen, then jack, and an ace, then the required probability will be 4C1 multiplied by 4C1 again, multiplied by 4C1 again, multiplied by 4C1 divided by, as I told you, 52C4. Okay, please solve this problem and give me the answer for this. I can show you the first one and then you can try the next one, please. Let us see the solution for this. Okay, four cards can be drawn from a Welsh shuffled pack in n number of ways, can be given by, as I told you, 52C4. Okay, now what's the formula for combination? It is n factorial divided by r factorial into bracket n minus r factorial. Okay, please remember and use this formula while doing the calculation. Now, one king can be drawn, as I told you, is 4C1. And similarly for the other three cards as well. So writing the formula, we can write 4C1 into 4C1, 4 times, divided by 52C4. Okay. Now, if you look at the calculation here, this will give me 4 each. So 4 into 4 into 4 into 4 divided by 52 factorial upon 4 factorial into bracket 48 factorial. Now 48 factorial can be removed from this cell because 52 factorial will be 52 multiplied by 51 multiplied by 50 multiplied by 49 and multiplied by 48 factorial. So I can easily cut off 48 factorial. Okay, from the numerator and the denominator, and this can be further written as this. So please note down this whole solution. Okay, and you can see this 48 factorial can be crossed out, and 4 into 3 into 2. If it goes up, reverse it, you'll get 4 multiplied by 3 into 2 in your numerator. Okay, and this finally gives you the solution 0.000059. Or you can write 00006. Now, such types of problems can be asked, whether combinations and permutations, Bayes' theorem, and probability will be coming together. Now, based on this, can we solve the second one, where it says two are kings and two are jacks? So what are the favorable cases that can occur, the number of favorable cases for two kings will be 4c2, right? Because they have not mentioned what type of king will occur. So the combination can be 4c2. Similarly, for two jacks, it will be 4c2. So the required probability for the second question, when we write the answer, will be 4c2 multiplied by 4c2 divided by 52c4. So let us see the second solution as well. Okay, two jacks and two kings. Okay, the number of favorable cases will be 4c2 multiplied by 4c2. Okay, and the formula required probability will become now 4c2 multiplied by 4c2 divided by 52c4, which will give me the answer as 0.00053. Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Okay, the last one, or the third one, in fact, where we have all our clubs. Now, if all our clubs, how many clubs we have? We have total 13 clubs in a pack of 52 cards. Okay, so the number of favorable cases in case of clubs will be 13C4. Okay, 13C4. And as you know, the total is 52. So that can be, probability can be written as 13C4 divided by 52C4. So in the third part, this is my third answer, which will give you 0.0026 as the answer. Now comes the last one. The last one says all are red or all are black. Okay, as you know, the total, there are 26 cards which are red and 26 cards which are black. Okay, and because they have used the or word in between, okay, so my required probability, whenever we use and, it is multiplication. For or, it is addition. Please remember the addition rule and the multiplication rule. So in this case, what will happen? The number of cases, favorable cases, for the last question will be 26C4. Okay. And because we have a or, it will be 26C4 plus 26C4. For the last one, so you can write it like this. And please remember, these are mutually exclusive events. Okay, so that's why the probability will be given like this. So the answer, you can see, is 26C4 plus 26C4, and that has been written as 2 multiplied by 26C4. Now that 26 has, I could not put it a superscript there. So it's still remaining 26. It's not 26C. Okay. It is 26 on top. Then C4. which can be written as 52 multiplied by 25 into 23 into 2 into 3 into 4 divided by the given values. Now, if you want, you can give a try here and check the answer. Tell me the answer for this, please. Please do the calculation and give me the answer for this. You can post the answer in the chat as well. So I have one answer, 0.110. Okay, Advait, right? The answer is 0.11. Clear? So you can write this answer as 0.11. Let us take one more example. This time, I am wanting you all to do it. Please give a try because these are the types of problems that will be asked on probability. Okay, the simple questions which we did at the beginning, they are not the ones. That was just the basic to give you some awareness about probability, nothing else. Now, these are the types of questions that are usually asked. Let us go to the next one. Take down this question. We have a committee of four to be formed. Okay. Now, from how many? Three economists are given, four engineers, two statistician, and one doctor. Now, from total, that is 3 plus 4, that is 7 plus 10. So, from 10 members, we are supposed to form a committee of four. Okay. Now, what are the two questions given to us? First of all, what is the probability that each of four professions is represented in the committee? That means I need one economist, one engineer, one statistician, and one doctor. Okay? So from each profession, there'll be one member in the committee. That's my first question. The second question is, what is the probability that the committee consists of the doctor and at least one economist? The remaining two can be from any of the options. That means one doctor is required, and at least means there can be more than one, but at least one economist should be there in my committee. Okay, as you know, as I told you, the total number of members are 10. So using this value, I would like you all to solve the problem now. For the first one, as you know, there are only three economists. So what are the different combinations that can occur from three? Is you can have 3C1, okay? Because we require only one economist in my first question. For the second one, for four engineers, we'll have the combination as 4C1, then we'll have 2C1 and 1C1. These are the four different combinations for different professions. The first one is very easy. What will be the answer? You can put it on the chat. And you already know the total members. Okay, total members are 10. So if I want to find out the different combination of 10 members, it will be how much? It will be 10C4, right? Because the committee needs four members. The value of R is 4. Any answer? Okay, one answer is in the chat. 0.114. Okay. 0.1142. Anyone else? Mm hmm. Any other answer? Okay, from Kadambri has said 0.114, Sagar has said 0.11, Advait has said 0.047, and Kushal has said 0.48. Fine, the answer will be 0.114. So if you go up to only two decimal places, you can write 0.11. And if you want to go up to four decimal places, you can write 0.1142. Now let us look at the answer, especially those who could not get it. It is very simple. See, as I told you, we have a total 10 members and we have to make a committee of four. So the combination, the ultimate combination will be 10C4. That means 10 factorial divided by r factorial into bracket 10 minus 4, that is 6 factorial. Great. So this can be written as 10 multiplied by 9 multiplied by 8 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 6 factorial, because 6 factorial is on top numerator and in denominator as well. That can get be cancelled. So we can cut it off. Okay. So the final answer will be 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 divided by 4 into 3 into 2, right? Or into 1 also, if you want, you can consider. That'll give me 210, right? Whereas we have from each of the, we have three economists for the combination will be 3C1. That'll give me only 3, right? If you remember the formulas which we have given, if we have NC1, the final answer is N, if you remember. So if I'm writing 3C1, the answer will be 3 there. Similarly for the others, because every way we have only one member from each of the group. Okay, so it will be 3 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 2, and doctor is only 1. So we have 1 multiplied by 1. So that gives me 24 divided by 210. Okay, so let us see this here. N members, as I told you. Now, therefore, a committee of four can be formed in total how many ways? That can be written like this, 210 number of ways. Any doubts in this? Okay. Now, if I have one economist, it can be written as I told you, 3C1, which will be 3. So the final options, the total number of favorable cases will be this year, 3 multiplied by 4, multiplied by 2, and multiplied by 1 will give me 24. So 24 divided by 210, that will give me 0.11. Either you write 42 or 43. Okay, because it's I think 0.114285 something. So I've written as 0.1143. So those who want to write up to four decimal places, please write this answer. Whereas those who want to go up to only two decimal places can also write 0.11. Both the answers will be considered as correct. Clear? Okay, anyone who's given a try for the second one? The second question, I'll come to the second question here. This is the second question. What is the probability that the committee consists of the doctor? Okay, now we have only one doctor, that will be 1C1. And at least one economist. Now, when they say there's only one economist, we have the other options as well. Okay, Shubham has given the answer for the final one. It is coming as 0.16. Okay, any other answer? Now, especially for Shubham, okay, when you're doing the calculation, you know, there are different combinations that can occur here. Now, they have given me only two options, one doctor and at least one economist. So these are my fixed conditions. So if I want to write different combinations, it will be one doctor and one economist. What about the other two members? So any other two members can be a part of my committee. This will be one, you know, scenario. The other scenario can be I have one doctor and two economists and one from the other members, because they have mentioned at least one economist, right? And the third option can be, the third combination can be, you know, I have one doctor and I keep all the three economists in my committee. So I'm not considering taking the engineers and the statisticians. Okay, so this can be three different combinations we have. And because these are the different options, three different options, we can have a or in between, right? So the required probability will have the addition formula used here. Okay, so let us see the answer for this. Any other one who's can give me some answer if you have tried it out? So if I think the first combination, that is one doctor, one economist, and two from others, your formula for probability will be 1C1 multiplied by 3C1 multiplied by, now the remaining are how many? We have 4 plus 2, 6. So 4 engineers and 2 statisticians, that is 6. From 6, I have to pick up 2. So it will be 6C2, right? Divided by 10C4. That'll be the first part. The first, you can say, possibility. What about the next one, where we have one doctor and two economists and one from the remaining six? So again, there is one more combination. Okay, let us see the answer now. So this was the first one. Let us take the second one. Now, the committee must have one doctor and at least one economist. Okay, so there are different compositions that can occur here. The first one where we can have one doctor, one economist, and two others. Or I can have one doctor, two economists, and one other. Or finally, we can have one doctor and three economists. We do not consider the other two professions. Okay. Now, using these three compositions, I can write my formula for probability. And remember, these are mutually exclusive cases. Okay. So mutually exclusive cases, we are going to make use of the plus, the addition formula. So this will be my formula. So we have 1C1, that is for doctor, multiplied by 3C1. Again, 3 will be on top. Please make a correction there. I could not put it in the upper script. Okay, so it is 3C1 multiplied by 6C2. Then put a plus sign, because this is my first composition, you can say. If I want to go for the other one, that is an or in between. So for or, remember, we have to use the addition and not multiplication. So we have plus there. Okay. And this can give me the answer as this. So 1 by 10C4. In the square bracket, we have written. Now, 1C1 will give me 1. 3C1 will give me 3. Okay, so 1 multiplied by 3, multiplied by 4, 6C2. We have 6 multiplied by 5 divided by 2. Okay, then plus, again 1 multiplied by 3, multiplied by 2, divided by 1 multiplied by 2. Something wrong there.
In the second condition, there should be 3C2.
Yeah, 3C2. That is something wrong there. I could not make the change. So while copy paste from here to here, this will be 3C2. Okay. This one. And that's the reason we have 3 multiplied by 2 divided by 1 multiplied by 2. Okay, there is a change here.
Yes, sir.
So while writing the answer, please see that it is 3C2 and not 3C1. Okay. Simply because you can see this 1 plus 1 plus 2 will give me 4 members. Here we have only 3 here. So this is 2 actually. Okay. And finally, we have your 1C1 and 3C3. Okay. Now, when you do the calculation, you'll get 64 divided by 210. And the final answer will be 0.305. Okay. Okay, let me make the changes here itself so that this one. This two. Because okay. Any doubts here? Great. Let us take one more example. Now, in this next example, let us see what we have. Okay. Now, the probability that a person stopping at a petrol pump, this will be the last problem which we'll be taking, will get his tire checked 0.12. So probability for checking tire at petrol pump is given as 0.12. And the probability that he will get his oil checked is 0.29. And the probability that he will get both checked is 0.07. Okay, so some probabilities are given to you. Now, this question I have picked up from one of the question papers. Okay, there are three questions given to us. The first one is, what is the probability that the person will have neither his tire nor oil checked? Okay. Second one, find the probability that a person who has his oil checked will also have tires checked. Since we are talking only about the probability from 0.12 probability, which is the people who are going to check the tires. From that, how many are going to check oil as well? And the third one, find the probability that the person checks tires but not oil. So there are three questions. We can take A as the event where the person is checking his tire, and B as the probability that, as the event that he is checking the oil. Okay, so we can take two variables here, A and B. Now, PA is given to you. PA is 0.12. And PB is given as 0.29. Okay, and what is 0.07? It is probability A and B, or you can call intersection, where we use the intersection sign. Okay, so PA and B is equal to 0.07. Now, what will be the probability that the person will have neither checked? Means neither the oil or the tires. In this first question, we can make use of the rule that the total probability is equal to 1. So if I want to write the formula for the first question, I can write probability that the person will have neither checked equal to 1 minus P, or the probability that the person will have either tire or oil checked. Isn't it clear? It'll be 1 minus probability that the person will have either the tire or the oil checked. That'll give you the final answer for this. So please give a try here. And if you get the answer, please post it in the chat as well. Now, what will be the formula for the probability that the person will have either tire or oil checked? It'll be like P, it'll or, right? So we have P, A, union, or sign. Remember the formula for this. You go back where I have given you the formulas. So it'll be P into bracket A or B. Now for P, probability A or B, we can write the probability function as PA plus PB minus PA and B. Remember?
Yes, sir.
Okay, anyone got the answer? Advait has got 0.59. Okay, Advait, this 59 is for the first one. And he's written 0.52, which is 52. You're missing on something. First one is 0.52. You're missing on something. It's not 52. Okay, Saurabh gives me answer as 0.66. Any other answers? See, the first one is the easiest one from this example, in this example. Any other answer?
Sir,
0.0348. No. Okay, Sagar gives me 0.59. Again, no. Okay, Saurabh is right. Saurabh's answer is right. That is 0.66. I'll share the answer with you. Just check it out. As I told you, I'll be using 1 minus probability that the person will have either tire or oil checked. So that can be written like this. Okay. We have taken A, that the event that the person will have tires checked, and B as the event that the person will have oil checked. Okay. So, and these are the values which are given to us. Now to use for the first one, I can write 1 minus P, that is the probability that person will have either tire or oil check. Now, what is the formula for P into bracket person will have either tire or oil check? That is PA or B. The formula is PA plus PB minus P A and B, right? So that has to be written like this. You can see this one. This is the formula. Okay. We know PA. PA is 0.12 plus 0.29 minus 0.07. Okay. So if you do the calculation, you should get 0.66 as the answer. Is this clear? Fine. What about the next one? The second question was probability that the person will have his tires checked who already has his oil checked. That means there is a condition, right? Given that, so it will be PA, probability that a person will check his tires given that he's already checked oil. So it will be written as PA, a line, B. Now check the formulas for this. So PA, given B is already occurred, that means oil is already been checked by him. The formula will be PA and B divided by PB. Okay, there's something in chat. Let me check the answer given. Okay, Advait gives me 0.24. Anyone else? Saurabh gives me 0.241. Fine. Any other answer? Okay, both are right. It is 0.424. That is the answer for the second question. So I'll show you the answer. Okay. So you can write this formula. It is P into round bracket A and B divided by PB. This is the formula for this particular problem. And we already have the value 0.07 divided by 0.29, which gives me 0.24. Okay. What is the last one? We have to find the probability that the person checks tires but not oil. Now here we have a not here. I'll immediately show you the answer because we have very less time here. Okay. Now we have to write the probability like this. P into bracket A and not B. Okay. So we have a bar there, B bar, not B. Fine. This can be written. So when we are writing the formula will be written like this. We have PA equal to PA and B plus PA and not B. Now, this is a very important formula. You should remember this one, especially when we are writing for PA. Now, and why we have given this not? This two things, from this two things, you find that here we have B, and here we have and not B. Okay. This can be reshuffled and we can write this formula like this.